I really latched on to the skateboarding and punk music, and I just remember feeling like this is who I am. You know, I'm angry. I'm angry and I can relate to this.
13-year-old Chris Jones was angry about his parents' divorce.
You know, I just lost control. You know, I was self-medicating. You know, I didn't want to be me, or I didn't want to experience, pain or frustration. I remember skateboarding to school high on LSD in seventh grade. And I went to my first rehab when I was 14 years old. I went to jail for stealing a car when I was 14.
By his late teens, Chris had a full-blown drug addiction that followed him into adulthood.
I was a human, garbage can as far as drugs. I would do LSD, you know, cocaine, speed, uppers, downers, all-arounders.
Chris wound up in rehab again. This time, he received more than drug counseling.
I remember I don't remember how it went down, but he just said, you need to give your life to Jesus Christ. And I'm like, what do I need to do to, because I hate myself. I hate the way I live. What do I need to do? And he led me to the Lord right there in the rehab, and I broke. I mean, that I just know it was real because I was broken. I was weeping.
Chris says he had a real encounter with God, but his addiction still had a hold on him.
And I got out of that rehab, and I tried really hard to stay sober. And I think I made it 4 months, and I went back and just did the same old thing.
At 25, Chris was arrested for manufacturing meth and sent to prison.
I got into the whole, prison gang life with the hate.
Chris spent 3 years in prison. Soon after his release, he was back to his old ways.
I was in jail again, and I believe God gave me that moment of clarity, that was like, what? Is this my life? The sum of my existence, this is it? And it was like, there's gotta be more. And I said, God, if you're real, please help me.
Chris received the help he prayed for.
I got into a 12-step program, and which I'm thankful for because it helped me establish a relationship with God.
Over the next 4 years, Chris made some big changes. He cleaned up and got sober, started a wood flooring business, and got married. He and his new wife, Tracy, also had 2 children. His relationship with God grew, but Chris still wasn't ready to give his life fully to the Lord.
You know, I was in a secular rock and roll band that took up a lot of my time.
When his wife Tracy started going to church, Chris wasn't convinced it was a priority. That put a major strain on their relationship.
I was either gonna divorce my wife because she was a Christian now or whatever, and go against God, or I was gonna step up to the plate and join. Well, we went to see The Passion. And it brought to life what Christ did for me. Whoa, Jesus Christ loves me. He loves me. And we're going to church, babe. that's what I said to my wife.
Chris and his family went to church together and haven't looked back.
I remember the very first time that Chris ever came to church and how he literally opened up, gave his life completely to the Lord. And so it's just really, really cool to see him come out of, rock and roll, prison, drugs, that kind of lifestyle, to where now that he's literally just a pillar in the house of God.
Chris decided to quit the secular band and focus on God, but he didn't stop playing music altogether.
He's the one that put it inside of me to love to play music. You know, God gave that to me, and God gave that to me to use for Him. So once I laid it down on the altar and gave it to Him, man, has He blessed my socks off.
God has also blessed Chris's marriage.
The Lord has done such a work in my wife and I. I will never be able to repay him for her, for my marriage. My marriage is beautiful now. And it was a wreck when we first got saved.
We would be divorced if it wasn't for, you know, our salvation, without a shadow of a doubt. He's the very foundation that keeps this family together.
God is so big and so good and so gnarly that nothing is surprising to him. Nobody's gone too far for God not to reach in and grab him and put him on the rock, because that's what he did for me.